Hey guys, how's it going? This is XPodX. So this PC has a hard drive for its operating system, so it takes a while to boot up. I am going to use my 240GB Crucial SSD, so that is going to improve boot up times and responsiveness so much. So I'm just going to do a test and going to speed up the process so you guys can see. Going to a 1600 by 900 resolution monitor, some base pulse go groove, little green LED speakers. They're not that great, but I got them because they're like really cool and stuff a long time ago. So, one of the fans is a little loud. I think maybe the green one right there, or maybe the black one right there. Taking a while. Oh. Alright, so now I got it booted up. Let's just go. I already clicked it. It's taking a while still. Just to do basic things. Control Shift Escape. Task Manager. Oh, it finally worked. Wow. Mouse speed is a little too much. I'm barely even moving it. Yeah, I already did Control Shift Escape. Still taking a while. Native Instruments. This is my music PC, and I also use it for some gaming if I'm rendering a video and I want to game still. But it's just, as you can see, it's just not responsive at all. This PC, I mean, a couple things, you know, like, yeah, it's trying to update Steam, and I'm trying to ask it a couple things, but it's pretty basic still, and like, yeah, if you wait and go to the bathroom, go have a cup of coffee or whatever, and come back, like, who wants to do that in the first place? And second place is still going to be not that responsive, you know, afterwards, still. Still hard drive. As you can see, very unresponsive. And the CPU and everything is not great. Has a Phenom 2X55 at 3.2. Still at 3.2. It's at 4% utilization of the CPU. It shouldn't be that way. Let me see. Control panel, and I should be able to change that real quick. So in control panel, go into hardware and sound. And then power options. If it's not using, you know, all of itself, it shouldn't be going to that frequency. So I think in balance, just kind of play with it and see which one works the best. So balance recommended. It still didn't change. Let me go power saving mode. This mouse speed again is too fast. And there, you can see it changed. Now it'll go up to that speed, its boost frequency, if it needs to, launching something that it, you know, a game or something, whatever the task is, so. All right, so it's been running for about 5 minutes. Just opened Chrome a while ago. It was trying to update Steam and Discord, and I opened up this PC task manager. So just like basic little things like that. And I opened up control panel and messed around with the setting to make sure if it's, you know, 4% or whatever, it's not gonna use the full, you know, base frequency and boost, whatever it can go up to. So yeah, it's, you can see it's working now, but it's not, you know, still not crazy responsive and stuff, you know. I can do that. Let's see, let's open up control panel again. It's taking its good sweet time. There we go, finally, and it, there you go. Okay, and let's go open up device manager. I already press enter. You know, load there. Oh, device manager. It actually wants to respond. Almost. But no information. Come on. Mm-hmm. There we go. Oh hey, look, it's working now. Alright, I installed the SSD, 4 screws in the back, took the side, rear side panel off, and then attached a Hudson cable going through here. I just rerouted them here. That's nice. I'm not the biggest fan of these, but then they get like, these are just clear looking, so it's kind of made it kind of cool with green. I had them laying around, I thought it looked kind of cool. So yeah, I just attached the SSD. Good now, and might as well update the graphics card a little bit too. I got a 962 gig just laying here, so I'm gonna install that. It won't make a difference in boot up times and responsiveness, but in games, you know, it should be a couple more frames, even though the CPU is not crazy great. And a 962 gig takes an 8-pin power. 560 Ti takes 2 6 pins. There we go. There we go. And 1 8-pin. This cable's a little bit short. Let me see. So I reroute the GPU cables. I reroute them from in here, and I went up above in this slot up here. I will show you in a second. Just doing a little tidying up. I need to do this with my main rig. She is messy. And I like care about that one more than this one. Okay, so yeah, that one's good. I'm putting the side panel on now. There we go. I know I can do it. Okay. So, this is a little bit older. Motherboard, and actually has a hard drive in the system right now for like games and stuff. I have a ribbon cable and then a state of power. So I routed this to this hole right here, this cutout, and this is the there's two parts to this cable. Put them together where they belong, which is this one. You'll see that the there's like a square side and then almost a square, and then have like a little tip at the end. They're slightly different, so it wants this one and that has to match up. And this groove right here, this little cutout, goes with the cutout right here, the little groove, so you have to match it up. And so you completely smush it together. But snug as a plug. Okay, that's it. Okay. Like so, grab your trusty zip tie. There. A cutting tool that barely works. And then nice. Okay, everything's good, golden. Excuse me, sorry. It is looking nice for an older system, but still like the best that I can, you know. It's pretty dang good, I think. Pretty clean for what it is. Making use of what I got. Powering on now. Both fans are spinning, which is a good sign. I'm display yet. Also has different connections, display port, HDMI, DVI. Okay, there we go. I might have to go into the BIOS and enable. Oh, frickin' heck. Yeah, it's not gonna work because this got pushed out. Dang it. Well. Alright, now it's plugged in correctly. Hopefully, it'll just boot off of the SSD. We shall see. I made sure Windows 10 is on it, and all the drivers, GeForce Experience drivers, I got Google Chrome, and that was, is that quicker? Should have been quicker than that. It's possible that getting, you know, devices ready because it hasn't been introduced with a Phenom 2X44. Phenom 2X4955 with a 960 and the other hard drive, which is a 500 gig and a 240 gig, I do believe, Western Digital. Let's see. But yeah, this case is alright. It's got a PSU shroud. It's kind of like a jet looking ass, you know what I mean? So it's got like the grill up here, kind of older style and plastic and stuff, but you know, it's still pretty decent. You can fit three SSDs right there. I think there's another hard drive available with another bay, and also a couple in the back, and another fan in here, which I could swap some of these two. I know it's a little messy, sorry. Yeah, that's definitely the hard drive. Taking forever and not getting devices ready. So these are 4-pin Molex, or the 3-pin fan header. Some of the board, which don't really want to clog it up and make it look messy, you know? But these ones right here are, like, I think exactly not that bright. This camera is looking like a snack. I'm just kidding. It's looking like that a little bit, but greener, like brighter green. Yeah, that's a hard drive for sure. Taking forever. But yeah, I'm gonna hook these up and take out this fan and put another fan there. So I have the whole kit in here, all five. That'll be nice. Okay, so the CT250 MX500, that is what this SSD, the Crucial one, is. It's an MX500 by Crucial. Yeah, so here's the BIOS, older, I know, crazy old. Let's go into boot and then go into boot. Device priority, and then you want the top one, so just kind of go through the plus boy over here. Plus, not working. It is not seeing. Plus, no, it's not seeing. Let me see. Go into hard disk priority. There it is, right here, the third drive. I want it to be the first one. There we go. So it is the first one now. And now escape. And then you want this one to be the first one. So it's going to see this one and boot from it. And F10. Boop! And yes. Okay. Let's do it. So yeah, while that does that, I'm going to install these two fans right here and make them look nice and get rid of this looking ass old thing. And there we go. Yeah, I think I'm gonna keep these little cable sleeves, I guess you would call them. But I did have this hard drive I was gonna put in it, but this one's broken. It's not seeing it at all. And it's making a noise too, I think. It's like a ticking sound. So I got it used for like $7 and I wanted to make do with it. But yeah, so that's not gonna work. I was thinking what else I can put. I can put this in there. It's a USB card. I think I have another card. So I think it was USB 3. I'm gonna give that to my dad. This one, guys. Back right here. I can pass it up to. But yeah, this has an i5-2500 in it. This was going to be for this PC. It was going to be so much better, and way better for gaming, and just overall activity, just and actually be like halfway, you know, decent and usable, but it just died on me, that board, so I have to spend like a good 60, 70 bucks on a decent board, and it's just like that. We are getting devices ready. I'm going to charge my camera and install these two, and then I'll do the test. Alright, powering on with the SSD now. I took out, because I added that fan right there, and it has a cable stretched over there and plugged into the motherboard, and then the fan down there has a cable alongside the back and hooked up to 4-pin Molex, and it's already booted up. So that's it right there. She's good to go. See? It's looking pretty nice, I would say. Okay, so go into control panel. There we go. Control shift escape, and let's go into device manager, and done. There we go. Go to YouTube. There we go. Oh, look at that video. That's cool. Alright, but yeah, I mean, it's so much more responsive. I'm gonna open Play Store and the game. And, oh, I want to see how much storage I have on here as well. But if here's a 240 gig, here's the 240 gig hard drive that was the on the operating system. And then here's the 500 gig. You know what? 500 gig was the operating system, and the 240 was games and stuff. So there's everything right there. Here's the game. Look at that. It's just so much more responsive. And I don't know if it's going to drop. I think it's going to drop in frequency. I'm just doing everything. The 960, here it is. Using 30%, but yeah, your Steam, it's like, boom, so much more responsive, night and day difference. Alright, NASCAR Heat 4, guys. I'm gonna play it at 1600 by 900, V-Sync off, full screen on, quality, let's go all the way up, depth of field off, show quality, okay, what about advanced, is there any advanced? I think there's a fan there that's being a little bit loud. yeah, I think that's maxed out right there. Safe. Alright, looks good to me. Alright, let's just play a quick race. And let's do that one, it looks fun. Alright, so 53 frames a second. A lot more slippery under. Alright, did I smash it up a little bit? Nice, this car is dope though. So, high 40s and 50s. It's not even using. I wasn't paying attention, I wasn't paying attention. Nice, it can stop pretty good. So I'm not even utilizing all of the CPU or the GPU at 69% and 33%. It gets to 6. It got up to 60% for a second. Oof. My bad. Okay, I'll try again. Come on. Oops. I'm better on pavement, I swear. I have other gameplay of this, if you guys want to see that one. It's really cool. I'm bursting one of my friends. This is rough. Little Nidhogg 2 for you guys. My controller works for this. That's the highest it can go. Full screen. You guys are easy, come on. We need competition. Yes. Ouch! I'm dead. Oh, I forgot you can throw it. Ouch, that was ouchy. Oh, try to kick him and then get stabbed in the throat. Just whatever. Ouch. Got him. Nope, don't got him. I gotta win this one. He's beat me. Got him. How do you block it again? Got it. Looking at the screen. Come on. Hitting me. You got me the next stage. Come on. Ouch. I got this, guys. I guess not. I don't have it. What? Got knife! No! Again! Nice. Suicide. Just stomach open. You did. Alright guys, if you like this video, like it, subscribe, whatever you guys want to do, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace!